Hi, my name is Janelle, and I identify as Guyanese American.
Hi, my name is Julia, and I identify as Jamaican American.
Hi, my name is Nassian, and I identify myself as Jamaican American.
Hi, my name is Loanne, and I'm also Jamaican American.
When people think of the Caribbean, they think of like Jamaica, Bahamas, or like Trinidad. But a lot of the time, like, the lesser known countries are forgotten about. And even me, like, I identify as Guyanese, but since that's not an island as such, it's in South America, people tend to overlook it and not associate it with part of the Caribbean.
Well, first and foremost, people always want to argue with me, like, trying to make, like, validate the fact that I'm not from the Caribbean because I wasn't born there. But I heavily identify with the fact that I'm Jamaican. I've had a big influence as a Jamaican American in my life since I was born. They always want to do the accent like Wagwan or Jamaican me crazy, and it's so annoying, but at the end of the day, they just want to learn more about culture.
When I'm home, like, the food is there, my family's speaking their language, like, I just feel more comfort at home, but here it's not. No, I feel like in the media, Caribbeans are portrayed as aggressive and, you know, not as intelligent, but I feel like that's not true, and the media is very false.
The music, there are a lot of similarities between Caribbean music and music here in New Orleans. A lot of the rhythms are the same, so that's pretty fun.
My transition has been a very rough one because persons didn't truly understand me, because when I speak patois or even like some type of way with my accent, they would seem like what is she saying. I had to repeat more than once, but them I get to understand me now, and like Marilia and Julie, like here, you know, New Orleans, because it's a very vibrant environment and it reminds me so much of back home.